नमस्ते, मैं सत्रवेणी खुराना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मसाज इन एक्सरसाइज थेरेपी। मसाज कम्स इन डिफरेंट वेरिएशंस, टेक्निक्स इज अ की नेसेसिटी टू प्रोवाइड द परफेक्ट ट्रीटमेंट फॉर थेरेपी। द टेक्निक्स यूज्ड आर बीटिंग एंड पाउंडिंग, कंप्रेशन, कपिंग, डीप स्ट्रोक्स, एफलोराज, फ्रिक्शन, हैकिंग, नेडिंग, मोबिलाइजेशंस, मायोफेशियल रिलीज, स्किन रोलिंग, वाइब्रेशंस एंड ब्रीथिंग। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट बीटिंग एंड पाउंडिंग। बीटिंग एंड पाउंडिंग इज अ प्रिकर्सिव टेक्निक यूज्ड टू प्रोड्यूस स्टिमुलेशन। Beating and pounding involves a series of light, brisk, striking action applied with the clenched fist. Beating and pounding is a specific technique used to stimulate muscle before exercise. Beating and pounding stimulates an increase of blood temperature and tissue elasticity. Beating and pounding can be used effectively throughout a training program to help maintain healthy muscles and thus prevent injuries from occurring. Beating and pounding are heavier percussion movements and is performed on large muscle areas of the body, example thigh or buttocks. This technique is performed by striking large muscle areas with loosely clenched fist. It aims to produce deeper effect to an area compared to other percussion techniques. Beating and pounding is used to stimulate blood circulation to an area, reduce and soften areas of adipose tissue, and increase muscle tone. It can be used on many circumstances, such as pre-event or part of a training program. It is commonly used before exercise or a sporting event. The physiological effects of beating and pounding include increased capillarization, increased temperature, increased oxygenation, and increased tissue elasticity. There are many commonly body parts that can be treated with beating and pounding, and these parts are upper back, lower back, buttock, thigh and calf. Next we have technique is compression. Compressions are an effective technique used on large area of muscle. This technique applies pressure onto muscles. It is then held and released. This technique is then repeated. Compression are used within many different types of, such as Swedish therapy, deep tissue therapies, and it is an effective technique performed by laying hands over a muscle area and pushing down onto the tissues. Hands are then lifted and moved to a different area and then repeated. The pressure of compression can range from light to very deep. Compression can also be performed with a slight rocking movement that can encourage the parasympathetic nervous system, which promotes relaxation. Compression can be used to help on many circumstances, including relaxation, acute pain, and muscle tightness. Compression is used to help relax the body physically and mentally. Light pressure is applied across the soft tissues, increasing temperature and circulation. Increased temperature allows the muscle to soften and lengthen. Compression techniques can also help stimulate parasympathetic nervous system to aid relaxation. This technique used to relieve tightness in the muscle. Compression can enhance the stretch reflex in the muscle. Pressure applied can stretch the muscle spindle cells and trigger a reflexive contraction. rhythmic compression into the muscle also creates a deep hyperemia in the tissue. Hyperemia, it is increase of blood flow in the blood vessel. Hyperemia effect soften the muscle fibers so that they can be worked into deeper. As I said above, compression is used to treat acute pains. Compression onto a muscle can help decrease pain by reducing inflammation in the tissue, increasing blood circulation, and interrupting pain signal pathways. Inflammation or swelling within the tissue can cause pain. Compression can help flush out these excess fluids and relieve pressure. Compression can also encourage pain-free movements by eliminating trigger points and thus relieving tightness. There are some physiological effects of compression, such as increased vasodilation, increased endorphins, serotonin and dopamine, and increased cellular exchange. As compression increases vasodilation in the blood, causing hyperemic effect, which then causes vasodilation, resulting in widening of the blood vessel, which allows more blood to flow through. The increase of blood is beneficial to muscle tissue for healing and nutrition too. Compression also stimulates hormone in the body. Compression causes muscles and body to relax. When the body relaxes, the parasympathetic nervous system is stimulated. The parasympathetic nervous system produces hormones from the brain into the body, such as endorphins, serotonin, and dopamine. These help improve mood by producing feel-good emotions. Compression stimulates cellular exchange in the bone tissue. Compression initially constricts the blood flow and muscle fibers. The slight tightening of the muscle compresses the venous and lymph channels. The force onto the channels can push out waste products and toxins, which cause tissue irritation. On release, the increase of oxygenated, nutrient-rich blood is filtered back into the muscles. Compression has many benefits, such as relaxation, improved circulation, and increased healing. There are many common area parts of body that can be treated with compression, such as upper back, lower back, buttock, and thigh, and calf too. Next technique we have cupping. Cupping is the technique in which local suction is created on the skin using plastic cups. Hand cups can be used on any region of the body. Cupping increases blood circulation and is effective to release tight muscle, fascia, and reduce high tone. Can use cupping as an effective massage technique to treat a range of conditions. Cupping is a vacuum type technique performed with handheld cups. Placing suction cups on the body creates a partial vacuum to reduce tension on the skin and tissues underneath. By creating suction and vacuum pressure, it can soften skin tight muscles, loosen adhesions, and lift up restrictive connective tissue. The specific technique brings hydration and blood flow to the body tissue. It can be used to move deep inflammation to the skin surface to release and drain excess fluid and toxins by opening lymphatic pathways. Cupping can be used over any region of the body as long as there is a seal between the skin and cup. Therefore, cupping is more suited to large areas of muscles. Cupping can be used to help on many circumstances, such as post-event. It is used for tight muscles or high muscle tone. This can produce many important physiological effects on the body, such as increased temperature, removal of waste products, and decreased cortisol. As increases temperature of the tissue, which help to relax muscles and help decrease tension. Cupping stimulates temperature by increasing blood flow to an area. Vacuum pressure lifts tissues up and can turn skin red, indicating that the circulation has been brought to the surface. Increased blood flow brings more nutrients and oxygen to the tissues. Cupping can also stimulate the removal of waste products in the tissues. During an increase of blood flow, waste products and toxins are removed. The removal of waste products can lead to healthier muscle and thus prevent tension buildup. Cupping can produce relaxation and decrease cortisol in the body. Cortisol is a stress hormone. When cortisol is released from the brain, emotions of stress and anxiety can be felt. Cupping increases temperature and sedates the nervous system. Stimulating the nervous system decreases the feeling of stress and is replaced by emotions of calmness. Its benefits are decreased tension, relief of tight muscles, improved circulation, and relaxation. Cupping can be treated for body parts such as arm, upper back, lower back, abdomen, thigh, and calf. Now, our next technique is deep strokes. Deep strokes are an effective and beneficial technique. Deep strokes are performed along the direction of muscle fibers. Deep strokes can be performed over many body parts and are used to increase tissue elasticity and relaxation. Deep strokes can be used as part of many different therapies such as Swedish and deep tissues. Deep strokes are performed along the same direction of the muscle fiber. It can be performed with the palm of hand or the forearm. Pressure during the stroke should be deep and reaching underlying muscle structure. Deep strokes are used to lengthen and mobilize soft tissue and help improve functions of the joints. Deep strokes are used to help in many circumstances such as relaxation and delayed onset muscle soreness. Deep stroke can help increase the temperature of body and stimulate parasympathetic nervous system. The friction to the skin through the strokes helps to increase the temperature of soft tissue. Increasing the temperature of soft tissue allows muscle to relax. Deep stroke performed gently onto the muscle can also stimulate parasympathetic nervous system, which is responsible for stimulating the rest response. The parasympathetic allows the body to relax and feel a sense of calmness. Emotions such as anxiety and stress are decreased when the parasympathetic nervous system is stimulated. Deep stroke can also be an effective technique to DOMS. DOMS can occur in muscles after intense or strenuous exercise that the body is not used to. The symptoms of DOMS include fatigue, tightness, and muscle soreness. Muscle soreness is the cause of microscopic tearing of muscle fiber. Tearing can be associated with inflammation in the muscle, which causes pain. Deep stroke help reduce tightness and pain by increasing the temperature of the muscle, reducing inflammation, and removing acids and toxins from out of the tissue. Treating DOMS with this technique can improve muscle recovery and allow participation in the exercise to be continued. This technique can produce many important physiological effects on the body, such as increased venous return, increased temperature, increased tissue elasticity. Venous return, it is the amount of blood returning back to the heart. The application of the stroke can be performed in an upward direction towards the heart. This type of deep stroke increases blood circulation and moves it towards the direction of the heart. Increased venous return is beneficial to improving blood circulation. Deep stroke technique has many benefits such as improved recovery, decreased pain, reduced swelling, and relaxation. During rehabilitation stage of injury or post-surgery, it is helpful. Deep strokes can treat tight muscles and help decrease pain. After injury or surgery, soft tissues can become tight and lose their normal function. Deep strokes can increase the blood circulation, which can help in the healing of damaged tissue. Deep strokes can also increase the tissue elasticity and reduce tight tissues such as scar as adhesions. Thank you.